Let's go. How's my hair look? You know what? Hold on. Every day's a good hair day when you have a hat. Let's do this. Hey there, guys. This is Gavin, aka the Gear Goblin of Eastrico Productions. Unfortunately, Anthony won't be joining us today because he has absconded to Italy for at least 2 weeks' time to enjoy some full-bodied wines. So we know he deserves a break, and now you guys are stuck with me for our gear review for today. So this week, we wanted to highlight a portraiture build that we're working on for a gig that's coming up in May, and we were looking for a portrait photography solution that would give us the ability to take a lot of photos, really high quality portraits in rapid succession. We have a lot of volume for this upcoming gig. So after doing some research, we found the Westcott Eyelighter 2, which is a crescent moon shaped reflector you put directly in front of your subject. And we paired that with the Flashpoint Explore 600 Pro. This one is non-TTL, which means it's going to take its measurements through the flash itself. We also paired it with the proprietary transmitter for Nikon cameras. So all of the stills that you're going to be seeing were taken on Nikon. Most all of the portraits that we have taken for clients in the past have used consistent lighting, and we wanted to see what we could do with some flash lighting products. So we looked for the Flashpoint Explore 600 to be that solution for us. So as you can see, we have the same setup with both our consistent lighting and with our flash lighting. That's the Crescent Westcott Eyelighter 2 in front of the subject, close enough so that it's providing that bounce. A little backlight on the 120D with a double honeycomb in it, just to give a little kick in the background. Now, you'll notice that in the consistent lighting, it's really good, really soft features. We have not too many shadows on Bree's face there, and generally speaking, it's just a solid portrait. Now, when we move on to the flash lighting, there's an immediate palpable difference. The photos seem a lot sharper, the color in her face seems more vibrant, and the contrast seems a little higher as well. You'll notice that the background is less washed out. Now, generally speaking, there are pros and cons to consistent lighting versus flash lighting. That being said, most professional portrait photographers are always gonna opt for flash lighting. That's because it's brighter, you can overcome ambient light, the images tend to look a lot sharper, and you have a better time of letting that fall off occur in the background. Now, I'm not gonna get into the nitty-gritty of flash photography versus portrait photography with consistent lighting. There's a lot of pros and cons, and I think it really depends on what your personal preference is and what sort of environment you're shooting in. The elegance of this setup for us is sort of the ability to go run and gun with it. A flight across the country, we're able to take this Westcott in one small, probably 2x4 ? I'm looking at Nora right now because I'm not really sure about measurements. She's also shrugging. It's 2x4, let's say for the sake of argument. Also, just one light that comes in a small box and a stand, and that's all you need in order to take some great photos. Lightning round, super portable. Only need the light, the camera, and the bounce. You've got nice soft photos, really soft features. Everybody loves it, it's beautiful, very, very flattering, and that is the key when it comes to portrait photography. And not for nothing, but the setup is really easy. I just kind of put the wireless transmitter on the Nikon. It communicated without me having to do much calibration with the camera. So depending on your skill level, you can either have a tremendous amount of control over how the flash behaves, or you can just kind of point and shoot and you'll get really pretty results either way. Have you guys ever used any of the Flashpoint lights before or the Westcott bounce? I'm digging it right now. It's actually right in front of me, giving me some nice soft light. If you have any thoughts, go ahead and throw those in the comments below. And yeah, thanks for watching. Until next time. Yeah, finger guns.